motion. The purpose of doing them is to put your knees in situations that you're not normally in.
We're really good in this volleyball program of educating them of what they're doing, making it so individualized that like each program is specific to their needs. We're kind of always on the cutting edge of technology. We were one of the first volleyball programs in the nation to use Catapult. It's a wearable technology that we have the athletes use to get readings such as jump heights, player loads, and all kinds of data to help us analyze and periodize a plan for them.
We look back and say, okay, here's what it means to play the sport in a game context. Now, how are we preparing for the sport? What do our practices look like? What's our volumes? What's our intensities? What's our pace of play? So it's really important to have these numbers that allows us to design the rest of the program.
This summer, I had to make sure that we are ready to get into preseason so everyone is safe, healthy, to keep their performance where needed, but also to push the boundaries to make sure we're reaching that elite level that we need. The best ability is availability, and if they're not available to play, they're not a benefit to themselves or the team. So making sure that we're using this technology to make it the most individualized approach that we can.
The thing I love the most about working with Dr. Bill and the sports science team, Casey, our strength coach, is how collaborative we are, even with our nutrition program. We use that as the central point in which all of our support staff works together. And so it gives us a scientific output for a starting point for us to have our conversation.
We're looking at this information, especially during practices, but mainly for me with conditioning sessions. I need them to hit certain loads, change of directions, I'm monitoring jumps a little bit more, so I know if this is more specific to them and where I need them to go.
I'm not just gonna have the data and go, you know, off the rails and make my own decisions that put them in jeopardy. So when I say it's a hard day, no matter how hard it feels for them, they're gonna keep pushing. They trust that they have that ability.
We wanna have a program that continues to maintain the highest of standards of training and performance preparation.
The support we're getting from Michigan State, especially having experts to analyze women-specific data, is helping us further the research. There's not a ton of research out there for women's sports, not just in technology, but in strength and conditioning as well. And we are trying to push those boundaries and look into new topics from like sports science to even like hormonal-based training, things like that, to kind of keep pushing the boundaries, because as female athletes, they're just as important as the men.
1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3!